Hello, welcome to the sky this week. Let us have a brief overview of night sky of the upcoming week. Let us start as usual with identifying the pole star, which marks the rotation axis of Earth. Constellation Cassiopeia, which is just above the horizon, can be used to locate the pole star. Some of the stars around the pole star can be seen all through the night. They are called circumpolar stars. They never seem to set. The radius of the region where these circumpolar stars are seen depends on the latitude of the place of observation. For example, all the stars within 13 degrees from pole star are circumpolar for Bengaluru. Stars outside this boundary rise and set. For the person observing from the polar region, pole star will be at zenith and all the stars above the horizon are circumpolar. That is, they never set. Just think, how will you find out which is east and which is west? Now, let us turn towards northeast, where the great square of Pegasus is just above the horizon. Although Aquarius is well above the horizon, most of the stars are faint, so difficult to observe them during this season. Towards southeast is Fomal Heart of Pisces Austrinus. Bright planets Jupiter and Saturn, which are just 14 degrees apart, are above the southern horizon in the evening sky. They rise around 4:30 p.m. in the evening and set at 1:30 a.m. midnight. Arcturus or Swati of Bootes constellation is in the western sky well above the horizon. Now let us see pre-dawn sky. Brilliantly shining Venus rises around 4 in the morning. This week, Venus can be observed moving towards the star cluster called Beehive in Cancer. And on 13th of September, it will be very near the cluster. Mars in Pisces rises around 9 pm and sets at dawn. This week, Mars starts its retrograde motion, so seen moving westwards. Popular and easily recognizable constellations: Taurus, the Bull; Gemini, the Twins; and Orion, the Hunter, are in the eastern sky. Sirius, the Dog Star, is to the south of Orion. This star, which is brightest of all stars visible in the night sky, is about 25 times brighter than our Sun. Canopus or Agastya and Acherner can be seen in the southern sky. At dawn, you can see Cassiopeia well above the pole star. By now, it has traveled halfway around the pole star. We have observed that Moon moves about 13 degrees across the sky in a day. This week, there is an opportunity to scale the size of constellation using the motion of Moon. This week, Moon can be seen at dawn moving in Taurus for 4 days from 8th to 11th September. This observation can teach us how to approximately measure the extent of this constellation or its coverage area in the sky. On 12th and 13th September, Moon moves in Gemini.